Good evening, everyone. Today, we're going to play a quiz called Country Names in Other Languages. In this quiz, we'll be given different names of a country in different languages, in three different languages, and we have to guess which country is being mentioned here. So, there are 24 countries in this quiz and 12 minutes time. So, let's go. The first one is pretty easy. In Armenian, the name of this country is Hindkistan. In Bengali, it's Bharat Barsho. And in Hebrew, it is Hodu. So, from the Bengali name, Bharat Barsho, I think it is pretty obvious which country we are talking about. India, yes. They also gave description, a small description on the site. Names from India are Hindustan and originate in the name of the rivers Indus or Sindhu River or Bharata, similar names from these ancient Sanskrit texts, the Puranas. The next one is also pretty simple. Yunnan in Nepali, Gurdjieffa in Bulgarian, Hellas in Norwegian. Yunnan is a very common name in Indian or Sanskrit based languages spoken in India for Greece. Yunnan is also the name in Persian for Greece, and Yunanistan is what the Turks call Greece. It is all based on the Greek region of Ionia, which is ironically on the Turkish coast now. And Gurdjieffa is from Graecia, which is Latin name for Greece. And Hellas is Hellas, which is the native name for Greece, the Greek name for Greece. The Norwegians call the Greeks by their own name, so Greece. The next one is Sarfat in Hebrew, Saprangeti in Georgian, and Gallia in Greek. Gallia is a name of a historical region in France. Before, it was conquered by the Roman forces, and the Celtic-speaking Gauls were gradually converted into the Romance-speaking French. And the answer to and Saprangeti sounds a lot like a, you know, distinct, very divergent pronunciation of the word France. Saprangeti. The French themselves are named after a Germanic tribe called Franks. And the next question is the answer to the next question from Prima Facie is a neighbor of France, Alimentan. So the southern Soto and Nahuatl, which is an indigenous language of Mexico, Saxum Estonian is the language of Estonia, and southern Soto is the language spoken in South Africa and Lesotho. In Toichi is an alternate pronunciation of Deutschland. Alimentan comes from the Germanic tribe Alemanni. In many languages, Germany is known as Alemannia. And Saxama is based on the German tribe Saxons. And there are two separate regions called Saxony in Germany, also based on the Germanic tribe Saxons. So, Germany is the answer to that question. German has a number of exonyms origin, including some based on the Saxon tribe and other based on Alemanni. The Latin Germania is also common origin. Deutschi. Names from the indigenous one, Deutschland comes from the root Deutsch of the people. So, Deutschland, it means land of the people. So next question. Pau Grusi in Cornish, an extinct Celtic language which is spoken in Cornwall in England. Kartulsuyu in Quechua, a language which is spoken in the Andean countries like Peru, Ecuador, Chile, the language of the Inca Empire. And Brastan in Armenian. I think the answer to this question is a neighbor of Armenia, which is Georgia. The indigenous name of Georgia is Sakartvelo, after the ancient region of Kartli. which was adopted into some languages like Quechua and Esperanto. The Quechua name is based on Kartli or Sakartvelo, and that's how I guess the name of this country. And Gruzi, I think, comes from Georgia, and Vrastan, I have no idea where it comes from. Well, the Armenian name comes from the root work, which means wolf in Persian. The next question is Viro in Finnish, Aishani in Chinese, and Isutunia in Inuktitut. Inuktitut is a language spoken in northern Canada by the indigenous people in the polar, really frigid in the polar regions of Canada. And Isutunia sounds a lot like Estonia, so let's go with that. Okay, where does the Finnish come? The Finnish name comes from the Estonian province of Viruma. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Lengyelor Swag in Hungarian, Bulanda in Arabic, and Anfolain in Irish. Bulanda pretty much gives it away because the Arabic language doesn't have the letter P. So Bulanda would be Polanda, which would be Poland. And the Lengyel Slovak, the Hungarian name is based on the Lendian tribe or Lech tribe, which are the founding tribe of the Polish people. And Anfolain is just an Irish pronunciation of the word Poland. The next one is called, next country is called Kitai in Belarusian, Tiongkok in Indonesian, and Siena in Afrikaans. Siena is China, and Kitai is based on Kitai, which was an ancient Mongolic tribe which ruled parts of northern China, and because of that, in many countries China was known as Kitai or Cathay. The modern Hong Kong Airlines Cathay Pacific is also based on this name. I don't know. Tiongkok, the Indonesian name is based on the Chinese name of China, Zhongguo. Okay. Xiongali in Chinese, Vengria in Russian, and Majaristan in Azeri. So the people who founded the country of Hungary were called Magyars or Magyars. And that is why they're called, in the Hungarian language, Hungary is known as Magyar Szlovák. And in Turkish and the related Azeri language, it is known as Majaristan. So this is Hungary. And Xiongyali is just the Chinese pronunciation of Hungary. I don't know where Vengria comes. Oh, Vengria comes from the Onogur tribal union. Onogur was a Turkic, Bulgaric Turkic tribe which was present for a time in Pannonia, in the Pannonian basin where Hungary is currently based, and it's also the root of the more English name for the country, which is Hungary. The next question is Triu Tien in Vietnamese, Korea in Serbian, and Solongos in Mongolian. Korea in Serbian is just a transliteration of the word Korea. Again, the next one, Japon, Ilbon, Al-Yaban, is just a transliteration of Japan in different languages. Ikupi, Abeshistan in Crimean Tatar, and Habesha in Malay. Habesha is one of the alternate names of the country of Ethiopia, and which is probably the indigenous name as well. And it's the name by which it is mentioned in religious texts. Ethiopia. Most countries call Ethiopia ancient name. Habesh, an Arabic root, forms the origin of a number of derivations, including the English Abyssinia. Yeah, Abyssinia is the old English name for Ethiopia. Vermania, the next one is Vermania in Greek, Myanmarsko in Slovak, and Foma in Thai. Myanmarsko makes it pretty simple. It is Myanmar. I think Foma is just the Thai pronunciation of the word Burma. Myanmar or Burma has two names in many languages, though usually the one term is more common. Most of these came from a common root, perhaps from the Sanskrit word Brahma, as is promoted by the government of Myanmar. Okay, no arguing with that. So the next one is Ain Idalit in Scots, Vlocky in Polish, and Idali in Navajo. Idali in Navajo is Italy in English, and Vlocky in Polish is also Italy in English. Vlocky is interesting because Vlachs are another name for Romanians, who speak a language related to Italian and are found in Eastern Europe and are neighbors of the Poles. The next one is Elvetia in Romanian, Kuikilani in Hawaiian, and Isvitre in Turkish. Elvetia sounds a lot like the Latin word Helvetica for Switzerland, and Isvitre sounds like Swiss, so this is Switzerland. Switzerland from Swiss, cantons of Swiss Confederacy, however the exonyms for Switzerland comes from Helvetii, an ancient Celtic confederation that lived in the region before Roman times. Rota, the next person, Rota in Sami, indigenous language spoken in northern Scandinavia, Thuidien in Vietnamese, and Svitjod in Icelandic. I think they're referring to Sweden here. Yeah. The most of Sweden comes from, most names of Sweden ultimately comes from the ancient Swear. Ooh, we're running out of time, so I just rush with these ones, last ones. Misr is Egypt. Thaisko in Yodaya. Thaiguk is Thailand. Maghribia is Morocco. Meiguo is Chinese for USA. Nimsa, Aitrisi is Austria. Vinaya, I have no clue. The second last one, I have no clue. Paizo's back source is Netherlands. I know that. We have officially run out of time. Okay, so let's see which ones I missed. 92%. Not too bad. The ones I missed was Vinaya, Krievia, and Ulusak in Inuktitut, which is a word for Russia. The names of Russia are often derived from the word Rus, perhaps after the Viking seafarers in the region from Roslagen, Sweden. That's also the root of the word Ruota for Sweden in the Sami language. Roslagen region in Sweden. Swedish Vikings were from the core of the Russian state, and the state of Kievan Rus, which is found there, which is consisted of Ukraine, Belarus, and Eastern Russia. And Brosaus in Breton. Breton is a Brittonic language which is spoken in France from Brittonic immigrants from Britain, Great Britain, who settled in France during Roman times. And Paisos Baxos, Paybas, Paisos Baxos. These are various variations of the name for Netherlands in various Romance languages. It all means low countries, by the way. Also, the word Netherlands means low countries. So, Nimsa in Austria is called Nimsa in Arabic. I think the Arabic speakers got this name for Austria from Slavic speaking countries. It's written here. Look. The Arabic term might be borrowing from the Slavic root Nimoy, which means mute, and was applied to the unintelligible German speakers. Yeah, and it could also, though it's used for Germany by the Slavic speaking Eastern European neighbors of Germany, it's used for Austria by Arabic speakers, because the Arabic word for Germany is Almania, based on the Alemanni tribe. This one is called Meiguo for Chinese. I knew for a fact that the Chinese call Americans Meiguo. Apparently it means the Chinese form, which translates to beautiful, apparently it means beautiful country. Morocco, Maghribia. the word for west in Arabic is Maghrib, and also the western direction for prayer is called Maghrib. And Morocco is the westernmost Arabic speaking country, and it's officially known as Al Maghrib in Arabic. That's why I got this one. And Taisco, just a alternate pronunciation, Taiguk. Guk is just a common suffix for land or country in Korean. Yodaya in Burmese apparently comes from the medieval Ayutthaya kingdom in Thailand before they were destroyed by the Burmese. And Misr is the word in Urdu and Hindi for Egypt, from the Masr or Musr in Arabic. Yehpyet in Ukrainian, just a pronunciation of Egypt. Aift in Welsh, also different pronunciation of Egypt. So I think we're done here. Next time I'll try to get 100%. Till that time, signing off.